فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So this hadith, Bukhari narrated as well, not just Muslim. Bukhari narrated it in two places. He narrated in Kitab al-Tawheed and he also narrated in Kitab al-Tafsir. And what's very powerful is that the fact that Bukhari narrated this particular hadith in Kitab al-Tawheed, what does it show you? That this matter is a Tawheed related issue. It's a Tawheed related issue. And al-Bukhari rahimahullah, his tartibat of his abwab, and the kutub, the way he authored it, all of them show the fiqh of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. All show the fiqh of al-Imam al-Bukhari. One of the things that we take from this hadith, that first, and the reason why this author, the author al-Imam al-Dharqutni rahimahullah, he had actually brought this hadith is to prove Allah has a what? Allah has a qadam. And that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also has a rijl. That's why he brought this narration. And that the qadam is a what? Is a sifatun dhatiyatun. It's a sifa dhatiyya that is attached to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, not a sifa fi'liya, because a sifa fi'liya is connected to muta'aliqatun bi mashi'atillah, it's connected to Allah's mashi'ah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, this sifa is a sifa dhatiyya. It's connected to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. But also the other thing that we take from this hadith is the people who are going to enter the hellfire. And the people who are going to enter the hellfire, that this hadith mentions, يَدْخُلُنِي الْجَبَابِرَةُ وَالْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ. The people who are arrogant. The people who are arrogant, who are self-deluded, who are boastful, who are proud, they will enter the hellfire. And this is the type of people the hellfire takes. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the Quran, He mentions to us that the people were deviated and go against Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's command, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala doesn't allow the haqq to enter their heart of the arrogant people. Allah said in Surah Al-A'raf, سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِيَ الَّذِينَ يَتَكَبَّرُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. I deviate my verses, I turn my verses away from الَّذِينَ يَتَكَبَّرُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, those who are arrogant on the face of this earth. بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ, without any rightful reason. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ فَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مُنْكِرَةٌ وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Surah Al-Nahl. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ, your Lord is one, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. فَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ, the ones who do not believe in the hereafter, قُلُوبُهُمْ مُنْكِرَةٌ, their hearts are munkar. وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ, their hearts are rejecting everything that's being put towards it. They can't accept the truth even if it comes to them. Why? وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ, is because they are arrogant. And then Allah says, لَا جَرَمَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. Allah knows what they are hiding and what they are bringing out in the open. Then Allah says, إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْتَكْبِرِينَ. Allah does not like those who are arrogant. And you all know today, subhanAllah, if you look at the atheist, one of the sifat which are barizah, from the characteristics that are very apparent from them is what? Arrogance. And Ahlul Bid'ah are like that as well. They are very arrogant. Very arrogant. And that is why Allah diverted the verses from entering their hearts. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, وَلَا تُصَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورًا وَقْصِدْ فِي مَشِّيكَ وَغْضُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَصَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. Allah tells us subhanahu wa ta'ala from this verse, and the point I want is, وَلَا تُصَعِّرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. People who are arrogant, who turn their cheek away from the people. They can't even look at the people when they're talking to them out of arrogance. وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا, walking on this earth. You see how these artists and these rappers nowadays have kind of introduced this way of walking. وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا, it falls under it, لَا شَكْ. You see, it's self-deluding and boastful. And also nowadays, everybody wants to brag and boast. Even rapping and everything, all of that is what? Kibr. Yeah, it's kibr. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Allah doesn't like it. Rather, Allah tells us in the Quran that the day of judgment and Jannah is for the people who are humble and simple. You see, not for the people who want to be high and want to be arrogant. He says in Surah Al-Qasas, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًّا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The day of judgment, Jannah, It's for the people who do not want high. They don't want to be put in a high station in this earth. You see, they don't want corruption. And Allah says, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Also Allah Ta'ala tells us, كَذَلِكَ يَطْبَعُ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ قَلْبِ مُتَكَبِّرٍ جَبَّارٍ. And like that, Allah seals the heart of every mutakabbir and jabbar. And this hadith, what does it say? يَدْخُلُنِ الْجَبَابِرَةُ وَالْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ. The tyrant, arrogant person, Allah sealed his heart, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, every evidence is given to him, every point is mentioned to him, and you still see him, subhanallah, he still doesn't take it. He still doesn't take it, because the heart is sealed. If we look at the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, you see, in Imam Ahmad, he narrated in his Musnad, عن أبي سلمة عبد الرحمن بن عوف, that he said, التقى عبد الرحمن بن عمر, that Abdullah ibn Umar, sorry, أبي سلمة عبد الرحمن بن عوف said, التقى عبد الله بن عمر وعبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص, that Abdullah ibn Umar and Abdullah ibn Amr ibn العاص, they both met one another. When they both met each other, they started to talk, sit down, and they started to talk about على المروءة, morality. فتحدثا, both of them started to talk. ثم مضى عبد الله بن عمر. عبد الله بن عمر kept talking and speaking and speaking. وبقي عبد الله بن عمر يبكي. And عبد الله بن عمر was crying. فقال له رجل أيمان, said to عبد الله بن عمر, ما يبكيك يا أبا عبد الرحمن؟ يا أبا عبد الرحمن, what's making you cry? And then he said, meaning, why are you crying on what عبد الله بن عمر بن العاص is saying? Why are you crying for? And then he said, he said, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As claims, I mean, he's saying that he heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالُ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ مِنْ كِبْرٍ كَبَّهُ اللَّهُ لِوَجْهِهِ فِي النَّارِ. Anyone who has a mustard seed of arrogance in his heart, Allah will put him in the hellfire head first. ولذلك, there's a narration in Muslim which strengthens this meaning. Also, Imam Tirmidhi narrated it on the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet said, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبي مثقال ذرة من كبر. The person who has a mustard seed of arrogance in his heart will not enter Jannah. And then a man came up, he said, فقال رجل إن الرجل يحب أن يكون ثوبه حسنا ونعله حسنة. A man said, يا رسول الله, amongst us is one who likes his shoes to look good, his clothing to look good, he likes to appear nicely. And then the Prophet said, إن الله جميل يحب الجمال. Allah is beautiful and Allah loves beauty. But then the Prophet defined what arrogance is. Al-kibru bataru al-haq wa ghamtu an-nas. It's the rejection of the truth when it comes to you. And it is also belittling the people, belittling a person. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, قال الله, then this is hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-kibriya'u ridai. وَالْعَظَمَةُ إِزَارِ. Arrogance is my rida. Rida is what? The upper garment of the clothing. وَالْعَظَمَةُ إِزَارِ. And majestic is my izar, the lower garment. فَمَنْ نَازَعَنِي وَاحِدًا مِنْهُمَا. Anyone who disputes with me on any of the two. قَذَّفْتُهُ فِي النَّارِ. I will throw him into the hellfire. Some other riwayat, they say, عَذَّبْتُ. I will punish him. You see, another riwayat says, وَأَلْقَيْتُ فِي النَّارِ. I will throw him into the hellfire. Another narration says, أَلْقَيْتُ. I will throw him into the hellfire. I will enter him into the hellfire. Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, and this athar, and this hadith is in Musnad Ahmad. All of the ruwat that are in that chain are all ruwat sahih, Bukhari and Muslim, except Muhammad ibn Jabirin. Other than him, the rest are, but it's authentic. That he said, كنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, we were with the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, in a janaza. We were with the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم in a janaza. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ألا أخبركم بشر عباد الله. Shall I tell you the worst of the creation of Allah? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الفضل المستكبر. The harsh, arrogant one. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, ألا أخبركم بخير عباد الله. Shall I tell you the best of the creations of Allah? الضعيف المستضعف. The weak one who the people consider weak. ذو طمرين لا يؤبى له. لو أقسم على الله لأبر. His appearance is not attractive. The way he comes across is not beautiful. You see, he's weak in the eyes of the people. He's belittled. لكن if he swears by Allah, Allah will do it for him what he wants. Imam Muslim narrated, Nasa'i narrated, on the authority of Abu Huraira, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثَةٌ لَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Three, Allah will not speak to them, Allah will not purify them, and Allah will not look at them. وَلَهُمْ, and for them is a severe punishment. شَيْخٌ زَانٍ, a sheikh who commits zina. Means the old man who's committing zina. There's no need for you to commit zina. وَمَلِكٌ كَذَّابٌ, and a king who's a liar. You don't need to lie. Yeah? Why would a sheikh who's old in age have to commit zina? There's no shahwa pushing him. وَمَلِكٌ كَذَّابٌ, and also a leader. Why would he have to lie for? There's nothing. He's a leader for the people. وَعَائِلٌ مُسْتَكْبِرٌ, and a poor, arrogant person. Poor, arrogant individual. Those were the ayat and the hadith. If you look at this athar of the Salaf and the Sahabas, and you realize Abu Bakr Siddiq, look what he said. He said, لَا يَحْقَرَنَّ أَحَدٌ أَحَدًا, do not let one of you belittle anyone. فَإِنَّ صَغِيرَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَبِيرٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, because the small Muslim is the greatest in the eyes of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Muhammad ibn al-Hassan ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib said, who was the great grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or more like the grandson of Muhammad, so the grandson of Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, ما دخل قلب, it does not enter the heart of a person, شيء من الكبر, any arrogance whatsoever, إلا نقص من عقلي بقدر ما دخل من ذلك قل أو كثر. That will reduce, no one enters his heart any form of arrogance, except that it reduces his intellect based on how much arrogance entered him, whether it's a lot or little. And as I said before, my beloved brothers and sisters, one of the things that are very common now is the concept of al-ikhtiyal. Ikhtiyal is self-deluding. Allah mentions that in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ مَنْ كَانَ مُخْتَالًا فَخُورًا. مُخْتَال. Allah also says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that in Surah An-Nisa, ayah 36. In Surah Al-Luqman, ayah 18, what did he say? إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورًا. Again. And that point I need to bring it, which is the concept of how many youngsters and youths walk nowadays. That they should remember the hadith in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. And the Prophet ﷺ said, بَيْنَمَا رَجُّلٌ يَتَبَخْتَرُ فِي بُرْدَيْنِ. This hadith is Sahihain, from hadith Abu Huraira, that a man who was wearing, he was wearing two burdaini, two clothing. Yeah. And he's walking, enjoying himself, like the way he's walking, you know, with an arrogant walk to his walk. وَقَدْ أَعْجَبَتُ نَفْسُهُ, and he's fascinated with himself, the way he is and everything. خُسِفَتْ بِهِ الْأَرْضُ, Allah opened the earth for him. فهو يتجلجل فيها إلى يوم القيامة, and he will be dwelling deep into that earth until the day of judgment. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us another concept that many people need to understand. Will enter يدخلني الجبابرة والمتكبرون, is the musbil, the one whose garment is below his ankle. Because in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا ينظر الله, Allah does not look at, إِلَى مَنْ جَرَّ ثَوْبَهُ خُيَلًا, Allah does not look at the one who pulls his garment out of arrogance. Are you with me? So the one who has his garment below his ankle and he's doing this based on arrogance, Allah will not look at him the day of judgment. And he falls under يَدْخُلُنِي الْجَبَابِرَةُ وَالْمُتَكَبِّرُونَ. Now, pay attention. Can a person wear a garment below his ankles without arrogance? Can we say here لا ينظر الله إلى من جر ثوبه خيلاء. That I am not doing it out of arrogance. We'll say to you, if you do it out of arrogance, this hadith applies on you. That Allah is not going to look at you the day of judgment. But if you're saying, I'm not doing it out of arrogance, then you have another punishment for you. Which is what? مَا أَسْفَلَ مِنَ الْكَعْبَيْنِ فَفِي النَّارِ. Anything that's below the ankles is in the hellfire. So that punishment still stands for you. So whatever reason you do it, if you do it out of arrogance, then you get لَا يَنْظُرُ اللَّهُ إِلَى مَنْ جَرَّ ثَوْبُ خُيَلًا. If you say, no, I'm not doing it out of arrogance, rather I'm doing it out of what? Norms. Fine. Then we say to you, then what? Your foot is going to be in the hellfire. Anything below the ankles is going to be in the hellfire. Also, Bayhaqi narrated in his Sunan that the Prophet ﷺ has said, "Man ta'azzama fi nafsi," anyone who sees himself to be great and high and up, big, or ikhtala, or he's self-deluding himself, fi mashyati, in his walking, boastful in his walking, he's proud in his walking, laqiya Allah, we will meet Allah the day of judgment, wa alayhi ghadban, Allah is angry with him. He's going to meet Allah angry the day of judgment. Abdullah ibn Umar one day saw a man. Look at this. He saw a man, يَجُرُّ إِزَارَهُ خُيَلَى. He was pulling his garment out of arrogance. Abdullah ibn Umar said, إِنَّ لِلشَّيْطَانِ إِخْوَانَ. Wallahi, shaytan has brothers. And he repeated that two or three times. Rather, مُطَرِّف ibn عَبْدِ ibn الشخير. مُطَرِّف ibn عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الشخير. He saw Al-Muhallab. He saw Al-Muhallab. And he was wearing a jubbah. You see, he's wearing a big jubbah. And he was walking with arrogance. And he said to Abdullah ibn Mutarrif ibn Abdullah al-Shakhir, he said to him, Ya Abdullah! Abdullah ibn Mutarrif ibn Abdullah al-Shakhir saw him and he went up to Al-Muhallab. And he said to him, Ya Abdullah, O slave of Allah! هذه مشية يبغضه الله ورسوله. This walk that you're walking, Muhallab, is a walking Allah and His Messenger dislike. Muhallab responded to Abdullah Mutarrif ibn Abdullah al-Shakhir and he said to him, أما تعرفني? Do you not know who I am? You know who I am, right? And then he said to him, بل عارفك. Yes, I know you. أولك نطفة مذرة. When you first started, you were a نطفة. You started from a نطفة. What's a نطفة in English? Seminal fluid. That seminal fluid was what? Madiratun. The man just, it jumped from him. He just released it. Nothing, it meant nothing to him. وَآخِرُكَ جِيفَةٌ قَذِرَةٌ. And when you die, you're just going to be a dead flesh that has no value. وَأَنْتَ تَحْمِلُ الْعَذِرَةَ. And now you're carrying, within those two stages, you're carrying feces inside yourself. فَمَضَى الْمُهَلَّبُ. Muhallab walked on. وَتَرَكَ مَشَتُ. He left that type of walking from that day onwards. And who was Muhallab? He was a Malikan, he was a king. Hassan al-Basri one day saw a young boy walking with a beautiful clothing that he was wearing. And he, you know, فَدَعَاهُ. Hassan al-Basri called the boy, the young boy. See, if, like our youngsters, the way they walk and the way they act. So he called this young boy. He said to Yabna Adam, all the children of Adam, معجب بشبابه, amazed with their youth. محب لشمائله, they love their شمائل. What's the شمائل? Attributes and characteristics. كأن القبر قد وا كأن القبر, it is like that the grave قد وارى بدنك, it's like the grave has already taken you in. وكأنك قد لاقيت عملك, and that you've seen your actions, that you, mashallah, you've done everything good. ويحك, destruction be with you. داوي قلبك, cure your heart. فإن حاجة الله إلى العباد صلاح قلوبهم, because the need that Allah has from His slave is the perfection of their hearts. والاختيال دليل فسادها, and self-deluding and boastfulness is a evidence of the destruction of your heart. Arrogance is two types. There's an arrogance which is external and internal. As Ibn al-Qayyim mentions, rahimahullah. The internal one is what manifests on the limbs. As Ahlul Sunnah believe that what is inside comes out from whatever is inside, it comes onto the limbs. And that is when the person starts to see himself high and great. So a person starts to have this concept in his heart first, and then it starts to manifest on his limbs. So in other words, Ibn al-Qayyim says, arrogance can't occur unless there's three things in place. First is insan al-mutakabbir. There's a person who's arrogant. The second one is something he is arrogant on. Something, there's an object there. There's either, it's a human being, it can be other things, but he's arrogant because of, towards something. And the third one is a reason why he's arrogant. So let me say that again. There has to be the person who's arrogant, insan al-mutakabbir, the person who's arrogant, and there's mawjoodun yatakabbaru al-insan wa'ali, something that exists that the slave has to show arrogance to. And the third one is sababu lihadha al-kibr, reason to this arrogance. If I give an example of an insan al-mutakabbir, evidence for it, is qawluhu ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's statement, which is, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ سُلْطَانٍ أَتَاهُمْ إِن فِي صُدُورِهِمْ إِلَّا كِبْرٌ مَا هُمْ بِبَالِغِهِ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allah says, those who argue in the verses of Allah without any evidence, without any proofs, أَتَاهُمْ, that comes, إِن فِي صُدُورِهِمْ إِلَّا كِبْرٌ, in their hearts there's arrogance. So there is humans who are arrogant. So it's insan al-mutakabbir. This ayah shows us, it's an evidence that, are you with me, brothers? Are you there, brothers? So there's a person who's arrogant. Allah stated that. No one can say, I'm not arrogant. Or there's no human that can ever be arrogant. Arrogance is something that is present in a human being. It could be a characteristic a person can come with. What about mawjoodun yatakabbaru al-insanu alayh? Something that exists that the person becomes arrogant onto, then the evidence for that in Surah Al-An'am, Allah says, وَكُنْتُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهِ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ, and on the verses of Allah were you arrogant onto. So you see, there's something that exists that the slave has to show arrogance to. So you were arrogant from the verses of Allah, the proofs that were being brought to you, the arguments that were being put forward to you, you were showing arrogance towards that. The third one, which is a reason for that arrogance, is as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, and this is the one I mentioned right now in Sunan al-Bayhaqi, that the Prophet said, مَنْ تَعَظَّمَ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَاخْتَالَ فِي مَشْيَتِهِ. The person who glorifies and is boastful towards himself and self-deluding in his walking, لَقِيَ اللَّهُ, he will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day of judgment whilst he's angry. So the reason why the person will do that is because of what? His own self, to be seeing it high. He sees himself to mean something. Good. The types of arrogance there are. Or more like, the thing that a person can become arrogant to. Are you with me, brothers? If you're arrogant, then you're going to be arrogant to something. Ibn al-Qayyim says, يَنْقَسِمُ الْكِبْرُ إِلَى ثَلَاثَةَ أَقْسَامٍ, is categorized into three types. The first one is التَكَبُّرُ عَلَى اللَّهِ, arrogance towards Allah. And that is the greatest, that's afhashu anwa'u al-takabbur. It is the most evilest of the types of takabbur there is. And the reason why a person would do that is what? Sababu al-jahlu al-mahd. It is pure ignorance. The second one is al-takabbur ala al-rusul. So let me give you an example of the first one first. The first one, takabbur ala Allah, is qawlu Fir'aun. The statement of Fir'aun in Surah Al-Nazi'at. What did he say? فَقَالَ أَنَا رَبُّكُمْ الْأَعْلَى. I am Supreme Lord. Also Namrut, when he said to Ibrahim alayhi salam, what did he say to him? Ana uhyi al-mawta. I am the one who gives life and I am the one who kills. Also, when the people of Quraysh were commanded to prostrate to Allah, the arrogance they responded by in Surah Al-Furqan, what was it? وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ اسْجُدُوا لِلرَّحْمَانِ قَالُوا وَمَا الرَّحْمَانُ أَنَسْجُدُ لِمَا تَأْمُرُنَا وَزَادَهُمْ نُفُورًا. When it was said to them, prostrate to Allah, قالوا, they responded, وَمَا الرَّحْمَانُ, who is this Rahman that you're referring to? أَنَسْجُدُ لِمَا تَأْمُرُنَا وَزَادَهُمْ نُفُورًا. Arrogance came to them. The second one is arrogance towards the messengers. You see, arrogance towards the messengers. And that is again example of Fir'aun towards Musa and those who were with him. What did they say to Nabi Musa? أَنُؤْمِنُ لِبَشَرَيْنِ مِثْلِنَا وَقَوْمُهُمَا لَنَا عَابِدُونَ. And nu'minu, are we going to believe in two human beings like us? And their people were slaves for us once before, is to slave them. وقومهما لنا عابدون. Also the statement of Kuffar al-Arab. Yeah? When it came to the affairs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَوْ نَرَى رَبَّنَا لَقَدْ اسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ وَعَتَوْا عُتُوًا كَبِيرًا. If only angels were sent to us, are you going to send us يَمْشُونَ فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ, just walking in the market like us? A person, they belittled him عليه الصلاة والسلام. Are you going to come tell us that Allah sent you? Okay. What did they also say? The argument was what? وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِنَ الْقَرِيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. If only this Quran was sent down to what? The two qariya that were big, that were great. If only that Quran was sent down on it. Why does it have to be sent down on you, Muhammad? That's arrogance towards the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The other one is arrogance towards the people. Arrogance towards the people. And that is, which one was that? The one Iblis came with. أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ. He saw that he was greater than the creation of Nabiullah Adam. You see? So he believed that he's better than human beings because they're created from teen and he's created from fire. This exactly is what tribalism is like. And nationalism, that we're better than you. Indians are better than Pakistanis, or Pakistanis are better than Indians, or Bangladeshis are better than Somalis, are better than these people, and these people are better than these people. All of that, I mean, this tribe is better than this tribe. All of that, it falls under takabbur ala nasi. It is arrogance over the people. I am better than you, and you are lower than us. All of that falls under takabbur and arrogance. Inshallah ta'ala, we're going to conclude there for this class, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْهُ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.